Hello, hello. Hope you all are doing fantastic. I'm really excited to catch you all up in another coffee talk. And let's talk tea this time, or maybe whatever you have. Okay, so today's coffee talk topic is going to be how to perform a simple and effective life audit, aka how to access your current life. It's going to be an interactive video, so just grab a pen and paper or your journal to work on things. Also, feel free to pause the video anytime to work on the steps that we are going to discuss in this video. Okay. Okay, so we all do different kind of audits on monthly or everyday basis. For example, we do a social media audit by checking our insights, how our post performed, how many likes and comments we got on our post, etc. Or for someone, it might be doing your finance audit, tracking income, expenses, something like that, right? But have you done your life audit? It's really important to understand where we are standing right now. You can't plan your future or start working towards your goal if you have no clue where you are standing at present, right? And by where you are standing, I mean how your current life really is, how much you like it or how much you don't, and how bad you want to change it. So it all depends on these factors. Okay, let's get into it, like how to do a life audit, how to get your life together and finally come up with a plan to go from where you are right now to where you want to go. It's like the present you to the future you. Okay, so before we get into the action, let's see what is a life audit. Like, this concept I just learned from a blog post recently, and a life audit is basically the process in which you study and analyze your current life and then your desires and aspirations. So analyzing where you are and where you want to be allows you to think about which steps you need to take to achieve your goals and live your dream life, right? Okay, now that, why are life audits important? If you don't know where you are going, how can you get where you want to be? And if you don't know where you are standing, how do you know what you need to do to improve your life? Makes sense, right? So there is always a room for improvement. Okay, now let's get practical. How to do a life audit? Okay, you need to understand that it by no means a technical process that needs to be followed carefully step by step. Feel free to add any details on top of what we are going to discuss if you want to. So grab a pen and paper or a notepad and let's start. Okay, step number one is to evaluate your current life. Start by evaluating how you feel with your life as it is now. From 1 to 10, how satisfied are you with your average day? How do you feel about your closest relationships? Do you feel useful and fulfilled on a daily basis? Pause this video and write down how you feel right now about your life and how you feel in general. Get raw and real. Don't hide anything. Take it all out and just write it down. Okay, step two, write down your wishes, desires, and goals. Now that you know where you are standing, write down your deepest desires and wishes on a little piece of paper. Start going deep into your soul and discover things you hadn't acknowledged about yourself before and write them all down. It's okay if it's silly, just write down every bit of it. Now, step number three. Group your wishes by category. Once you have all your wishes and goals on your little piece of paper, start grouping them into different categories such as personal, material wants, experiences. When I say personal, it's everything related to the personal growth. Something like I want to be consistent in my work, and for material wants, something like I want to own a car, and for experiences, it can be I want to do scuba diving, and so on, until every wish and goal have a category. The next step is to group your wishes by time frame. Now it's time to set priorities. Decide which wishes, dreams, goals need to be worked on right now and which can wait. Step 5 is to make a to-do list to get there. Once you have all decided which ones are the most urgent to you, brainstorm the steps you will need to get there. Say for example, if you want to move to Canada, the steps would be you need to prepare for your IELTS exam, book your tickets for the exam, write your exam, apply for the immigration programs, like that, right? So start small with the basis and then get more advanced. Now step 6, make a list of people who can help you. You probably won't be able to make it without at least a little help, right? So include in this list people who can connect, people who can inspire you, give you advice or even cheer you on. Whatever help you can get, take it. You can also make a list of books you will need to read or courses you will need to attend in order to help you to reach your goals faster. Step 7, analyze what is stopping you and how to overcome the obstacles. Now it's time to grab your journal or your notepad again and start going deep into your soul. What is stopping you right now? What stopped you in the past? Again, get real about it and don't underestimate any reason or small detail. By doing this, you will definitely uncover the main obstacle that is standing between you and your dream life. Step 8, organize and place your wishes somewhere you can see them. You will need to place these wishes somewhere you can see them constantly, if not every day. I had placed a piece of paper on my work desk where I see them every day. You can also pin them on your vision board. One of the reasons why people never make their wishes come true is because they literally forget about them. They forget about that thing that they said years ago they want to accomplish. Don't let that happen to you. Keep your wishes at sight and keep working towards them. You will get there sometime. Like, you will get there eventually. Okay, now that we are all set, it's really, really important to take action. There is no brainer. Writing down wishes won't make them happen magically. You need to put it into work. Living without goals to work for is, in my opinion, is a pretty boring way of life. So I hope you found this coffee chat, aka interactive how to do a life audit, useful. Let me know in the comments below and also show some love by subscribing to the channel if you like my content, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.